What's up, guys? Welcome back to another epic day of experimenting. Today, I'm with MatPat, and we both have gas. You know, MatPat, what is going on today?
Fill me in. So today, we are doing some experiments with sulfur hexafluoride, or as we call it, SF6, not to be confused with Street Fighter 6. All you video game fans out there.
That's right. Today we're answering a comment request from GDNilo932, who says, do something with sulfur hexafluoride, please.
Please.
So, MatPat and I have stepped up to the challenge to do something with sulfur hexafluoride.
And boy howdy are we doing all sorts of things today. Your request has been answered.
So we've got an aquarium, we've got some balloons, we've got some tanks here. Can you tell us briefly what's going on, Matt?
No. Because this isn't my video.
Right, so is this something you've ever stopped to consider? Like, if you're living in a different place, a different atmosphere, mm-hmm. It might actually change the way that you talk.
I've never really stopped to think about it until just this moment.
So, we've got a few experiments that we're going to try today. You went down to the store and picked up this bottle of helium.
I did.
This is just party balloon helium, and it's actually, I mean, they do kind of dilute it a little bit. There's 20% air in here,
okay. But
guaranteed up to 80% helium. So, we all know what happens when you put your mouth over this, take a big suck, and try to talk.
Yes.
Hello, my baby. Hello, my honey. Hello, my ragtime gal.
So helium is six times less dense than air. So what happens is as you're speaking, your vocal cords vibrate a little bit faster mm-hmm. And your voice sounds higher. Now there's another gas that I'm sure you are all familiar with by now called sulfur hexafluoride.
Yeah.
Sulfur hexafluoride is actually six times heavier than air.
Mm-hmm.
So theoretically, it should have the opposite effect.
Right.
This is a tank of sulfur hexafluoride. It's actually the smallest tank I could purchase. It cost me $1,400.
Hashtag humble brag.
It weighs about
breaking in the dough.
I'm just saying it's not easy stuff to get, and it's about 50 pounds if you were to lift it up.
Mm-hmm.
So I think we got a lifetime supply, needless mm-hmm. to say, and it's got this thing that protects the valve, so that as it's rolling around a truck or whatnot, it's not going to accidentally spill out. So let's go ahead and take the cap off here, fill up a balloon, and see what kind of fun we can have with SF6. We both have two different color balloons here. I have a white balloon. My friend Matt has chosen to go to the dark side. In my balloon is helium gas, which is six times lighter than air, which means...
It makes my voice incredibly high, and this is an experiment we're all familiar with. Everybody loves helium. But on the other hand...
Sulfur hexafluoride is actually six times heavier than air, which means that when I suck it in...
My voice becomes super deep and super intense. Come over to join the dark side.
Get to the chopper.
To the chopper.
Here's the experiment. One half breath helium, one half breath sulfur hexafluoride. What's going to happen?
Just my usual, charming, everyday Midwestern voice, Grant. That's clearly what's going to happen here. So this is me. It's me, Mario. Now. It's me, Mario. Sounds actually fairly normal.
It does actually sound very normal.
Slightly too much of this, but overall kind of balances out.
This stuff is heavier than air, so it actually sits in your lungs. You can actually hear my voice is going through a little bit of a transition point right now.
It's like he's going through puberty.
Because the gas won't come out of your lungs unless you blow it out really,
sure.
Really aggressively, like.
And then we should be pretty close
oh,
back
man,
to normal.
We should do that.
And if you can't get it out, just stand on your head for a couple minutes. Should be fine.
It'll just leak out. Man.
Awesome. Okay.
That's crazy.
So now that we've demonstrated how heavy this gas really is,
yes.
There's an experiment that I've been wanting to try with an aquarium. Filling this gas up in an aquarium where it's completely invisible and bringing out a tinfoil boat. This isn't a new experience mm-hmm. for the internet.
I was going to say, it'll be new to me.
But it is a new experience for us. This is something we haven't tried before. So
awesome.
Let's go grab some tinfoil.
Let's do it.
You.
Alright guys, so here's the setup. We have a pitcher full of dry ice and a little bit of water. You know what happens when we mix water and dry ice, we get the really cool dry ice fog that vapes out.
What I'm trying to say is that we're gonna pour that vapor into this aquarium and it should show us the levels of the gas.
Now normally dry ice vapor flows to the bottom. We're gonna start pouring in some sulfur hexafluoride and observe the difference.
Are you cool. with me?
I'm with you. They might not be with you, but I'm with you, Grant.
Okay, that's actually good enough.
Woo!
Now, perfect.
See, this is the time in my life where I feel like a true mad scientist.
Yes.
Go in, my brains.
You can see the dry ice vapor flows right to the bottom of the aquarium. There's nothing to stop it. And it fills up the entire aquarium with that dry ice fog. All right, that should be good enough. What I want to see happen is if we release a little bit of this gas into the aquarium, like what's it going to do, if anything? It's kind of hard to see anything happening, isn't it?
Well, now that it's in there, though, if I pour in...
Yeah, try pouring a little bit more and see if there's any difference. Oh, what's really interesting is it's floating at the top.
I was gonna say, now you'll notice.
It's not going down to the bottom. It's like 3/4 of the way full with this invisible gas.
So guys, this was really unexpected. I had no idea that just that small bit from the balloon would actually fill up this aquarium 3/4 of the way, but you can honestly see the driest fog is lingering up here. So I think what we're gonna do is take this whiteboard, cover the top and take a little bit more gas and pump it in there.
Yeah.
And then we'll see if we can fill up this thing completely to where it's like literally at the top and we got this driest vapor just flowing over the top.
Let's do it.
Yeah. Woo!
All right, let's hold this right here. See, I'm thinking if we vent some in here, it'll push everything out there.
Cool.
I told you we had gas. Yeah. Okay, so now theoretically, if that worked, we will have sulfur hexafluoride pretty much filled this tank. And if we put in a little more dry ice vapor, we may be able to see something on the top.
Hopefully. Yep.
Whoa.
Yep. It won't even get into the aquarium at all.
Force field. Look at that.
It is. Yeah, you can see it almost like you're pouring water into a tank of water where you see it kind of dipping below the surface, but then it's popping back up.
That's making kind of an eerie fog, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, I feel like I've got some small water balloons around here. We should blow up some water balloons and see what happens if we put them in there. Does it float?
Oh, it does!
It does, it does.
It dipped down just enough and then it settled on the surface.
It's just hovering there. Well, it kind of stuck to the side.
But still.
Interesting. So it makes me wonder, if we can get a balloon to float, do you think something like a ping pong ball would be able to float, or do you think that would be too dense? That would just sink.
Oh, I think a ping pong ball, absolutely.
Really?
Should be an easy win, right?
What do you guys think? Post your comments below. Will a ping pong ball float on sulfur hexafluoride? All right, gas has been transferred.
Okay.
Ping pong ball.
Here we go.
I'm actually voting it's not going to work.
Really?
That's my vote. All right.
Let's do it. Let's see. There we go.
Oh!
No! Put to shame! Put to shame!
Yeah, it's just a little bit too dense.
Yeah, they're a bit heavy.
That would be crazy, though, if you could play ping pong in midair.
That would be
nuts. Like, if you could actually, boom. Oh, that's cool. Look at that.
That's awesome. Say, is this flammable?
It's non-flammable.
Okay.
Actually, it's
although I am curious, what happens if we dip this into the sulfur hexafluoride? It just immediately goes out.
Oh, wow.
And you can even see the remnant smoke from the flame floating on top of the sulfur hexafluoride level that we have in the aquarium.
That's crazy. Yeah, you can see it bouncing around. It's like a wave.
It just gets swallowed up. So, like what you said earlier, it's completely not flammable.
What's next? What are we going to do next?
Ooh, pick me, pick me.
All right, Matt.
Can we do that boat thing you talked about at the beginning?
Yes, we've seen people do little boats out of tinfoil, and basically the same thing that we just did with the balloon, except with one small twist, which I'll show you in just a second.
Oh, twist.
So grab the aluminum foil and let's see if we can make a boat.
Hit me with aluminum foil. All right, here it is. This is our best attempt.
Question about this, do you think it's gonna be wide enough to displace enough gas to like compensate for how heavy it is?
No, I don't, actually. I would love to be optimistic in this scenario, but let's be the crushing voice of realism here. This will not float.
Okay, guys, speaking of predictable, make your predictions now. Which boat is going to float? This one, or neither?
Or both!
Okay, if you don't mind, I'm gonna try this boat first.
Okay.
I think it has a higher chance of success. Oh!
Oh, no!
What the heck? I thought it was gonna work there for a second.
Did you?
I did, yeah.
I'm sorry. I never had hope for us.
You never had hope.
Here we go. This is Jason's boat. Here we go. Yeah, it didn't
work. What are we doing wrong, guys? Why can't we get this to work? Other people are doing it. Maybe our aluminum foil is too thick.
I think it's a combination of just the overall thickness of that high quality Target branded up and up aluminum foil, but also you'll notice we have a lot of excess in our boat.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I feel like the optimum boat for this is just gonna be like very clean folds, not wrinkled at all. Because all of these wrinkles are just adding to the surface area and the amount of tin foil that we're using in this case, thereby making our boat heavier and heavier.
That sounds fantastic. I'm going with what he said.
There you go. Boom, science, dropping knowledge. It work.
Oh!
No! I mean, it sinks really slowly.
It does sink a little slower. So you can see the fog is near the top here.
Yep.
We add our boat. Will it float? Oh, we are tremendous failures. Where do we go from here?
Man.
Do we keep pushing to make it work, or do we just accept our destiny and move on? Maybe we should build our boat first. We'll give that a chance to settle down. Build a boat, take the lid off very carefully, and try one more time.
All right.
All right, here we go, moment of truth.
Set.
Another boat, another experiment. Will it work?
This seems like it has the best chance.
Oh!
Oh, no!
It was right
there! You know where, I still stand by the fact, I don't know if we have to tape it or what, but it's these little folds. It's the areas of the folds where, I mean, it's a gas, right? And so just like water, just like air, it finds a way in wherever it can. And in this case, I think where we pulled it up the walls is where it's all creeping in.
I think you're right. And there's not really a lightweight tape. Like, if you add too much weight, it's gonna sink.
Right.
And if you don't plug the holes, it's gonna sink.
It's gonna sink.
So it's really a fine line trying to figure out how to engineer this thing.
Yeah.
But that, out of all of them so far, was
that
the
was
closest.
By far the best.
I just want to say, even though we had so much difficulty getting this tinfoil boat to actually work, it just goes to show what you see isn't always what you get. There are a lot of variables that come into play when you try this for yourself. Go check out Game Theory. It's really good, family-friendly, educational content, and you're going to learn something on every episode.
It's true, and we actually have special episodes on Game Theory with Grant exploring the Pokemon Fire World. On Film Theory, we have us doing some water-bending experiments that Grant helped us to do. And on GT Live, our live stream, we actually did some flavor manipulation, which was pretty wild, messing with our taste buds. So a lot of what you like on this channel, but over there, getting sciencey, getting even nerdier.
And of course, a big thanks to GDNilo932 for putting this request down in the comments. You can go ahead and check your YouTube inbox, GDNilo932. We're sending $25.
No, are you kidding?
For real.
He gets $25?
He gets $25.
Man! But most importantly of all, remember, that's just an experiment. A random experiment. Thanks for watching. Wait.
Oh yeah, there's definitely gas in there. You know, but that effect isn't quite as dramatic as I was expecting. I was expecting something a little bit heavier.
As a Canadian, do you say a boat?
Hey guys, I wanted to jump back in for just a second to invite you to come follow me on Instagram. I've got a very active page where I post daily pictures and stories of behind the scenes and every day is an adventure. Just take 5 seconds right now to click the link in the description to come follow me on Instagram at thekingofrandom, and I'll see you there.